We know that each of our network devices need an IP address in order to communicate on the network. But if we've got lots of devices, it could be a huge administrative burden to go to each device one at a time and configure all that IP address information. Fortunately, there's a protocol that can help us out. It's called Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, or DHCP for short. And we can have a DHCP server that can hand out IP address information to all of our different network devices. Let's take a look at how that works. Now, when I think of DHCP, I'm reminded of a show that my daughters used to watch when they were very little. It was on Nickelodeon. It was called Dora the Explorer. I think more recently there's been a live action Dora the Explorer movie. And the reason Dora reminds me of DHCP is the letters, D-O-R-A. That gives us the first letter of each message sent during a DHCP reservation. Consider this topology we see on screen. PCA just now booted up. It needs IP address information. Specifically, PCA wants an IP version 4 address. But PCA doesn't know the IP address of the DHCP server that's going to give it that information. So it sends out a discover broadcast. And a broadcast, it goes everywhere within a subnet, but it does not cross a router. Fortunately, in this case, we don't have a router separating PCA from the DHCP server. So the D in Dora reminds us of the D in Discover, which is the name of the broadcast that PCA sends out asking if there is a DHCP server somewhere out there on the network. Now, when the DHCP server receives that Discover broadcast, it responds to PCA with an offer message. Now, that's the O in the Dora memory aid. And the DHCP server's offer message tells PCA the IP address of the DHCP server. And PCA, it might receive more than one offer message coming in from multiple DHCP servers on the subnet. And it's going to select the offer message that it receives first. Now, in this case, PCA, it only received one single offer message, and it now learned the IP address of the DHCP server. So PCA, it's going to send out a request message. That's the R in Dora, asking the DHCP server for IPv4 address information. And finally, the DHCP server responds to that request message with an acknowledgement. That's the A in Dora. The acknowledgement message, it provides PCA with its IP address, subnet mask, default gateway, maybe other parameters, such as the address of a DNS server. But there's a bit of an issue if there's a router separating the network device from the DHCP server, as we see here. When PCB sends out its Discover broadcast, that broadcast is dropped by the router. The fix is to configure the router as a DHCP relay agent, which has the very unique ability to forward specific types of broadcasts, including those Discover broadcasts, to the specified destination. So here, router 1, it's configured to forward Discover broadcasts to the DHCP server. Now, when PCB sends its Discover broadcast, Router 1 forwards that broadcast to the DHCP server, and from that point on, the Dora process works as we've discussed. Now, this discussion was about DHCP for IP version 4. However, we do have DHCP for IP version 6, and those DHCP v6 servers, they can provide IPv6 information to our network devices. We have stateful DHCP v6 servers and stateless. First, let's take a look at the stateful servers. The DHCP v6 server provides all of the information that PCA needs. Specifically, prefix length information, it provides host information. Now, the prefix length, that identifies the network portion of the IPv6 address, and the host information is, of course, the host portion of that address. And the server, it can also provide some optional information, maybe the address of our IPv6 DNS server. Next, let's take a look at the stateless DHCP v6 approach. With the stateless approach, our PC is getting the prefix length information, in other words, the network information, from its router. Now, that's possible with an IP version 6 feature called Neighbor Discovery Protocol, or NDP. What happens here is we're asking the router interface, hey, what network are we on? And the PC can actually self-generate the host portion of its address. It does that using a process called EUI64, which can generate a 64-bit host identifier based on the host's 48-bit MAC address. Then, if there's extra information that the PC might need, such as the IP version 6 address of a DNS server, it can get that information from the stateless DHCP v6 server. And that's a look at how DHCP servers can hand out IP address information for both IP version 4 and IP version 6.